welcome to another Flash game. This is Infinity 4. And so, I'll go through the game and go through unlocking the weapons. Something I'd like to note, to unlock all the weapons means you have to complete normal and hard mode, as well as other things I'll explain along the way. There are specific areas with weapons as well. There are achievements you need to, which is mostly just you have to have a certain kill count as well for other weapons. And yes, it's a bit complicated, but I'll go through it. We're going to be doing a story mode, which is like just a regular game, and a couple other things as well. So before we do all that, let's actually go through the instructions. So we'll go through like the controls and things. So let's do that. I'm gonna open up this thing on game guide. Should bring us to the website. So let me see. Okay. All right. So on the website, it brings you a link to Crazy Monkey Games, which the game is on here as well. This is the tutorial, let me just scroll down. Okay, so with the controls, you press A and D keys to walk, left or right. Run is shift plus A and D keys, and then jump is W. Something I want to mention, you can jump further if you hold the run button and then jump moving left or right. So, and I apologize, there are ads on the website. It's just a thing you have to deal with, I guess, but... yeah, I do wish the tutorial was also on the game itself. I don't know if it is, but that's fine. Okay, so anyways, so, tap W twice, double jump, and backflip. Okay, so backflip is a very important thing you'll have to remember. So, WQ is moving backwards, and we'll be doing that a lot. Gives you kind of, invincibility against bullets for like a brief period. Don't think it's not, flawless or anything. You'll still take damage somehow, whether it's not during or after the backflip, but yeah, not always the best idea. Sometimes you will have to take cover depending on the situation, in my opinion. But usually backflip is good, and then you double jump, the second jump is the backflip as well. Now, I may not say that, but that's something else to keep in mind. So, yeah, both of these moves are very important. So, and then duck. It's a little situational. If you duck, you can't move. You can't dodge some bullets above you. However, certain weapons, like a shotgun, for instance, will still probably hit you even if you're ducking. So you want to be careful about that. So yeah, takes a bit of knowledge about these, like when and how to use these different moves. So yeah, which I'm basically trying to show how it works. So switch weapons is E or the mouse wheel. I prefer just doing pressing E. So, and melee is Q or mouse wheel button. So if you want to switch to melee, you can do that. Okay, so another thing. Let's go. Just a moment though. So yes, swap with your weapons in space. Now you can only carry two weapons at a time. So unlike the previous Infinity games, as I recall, where you can hold like multiple weapons, maybe like a dozen or so, or something like that. Only two at a time. So if you want to use a different weapon, what you'll have to do is defeat the enemy, drop one of the weapons you have, and pick up another one. Doing so, will reset your ammo count. So if you have a new weapon you want to get, but you haven't stocked up on ammo for, it may not have a block, so keep that in mind. Usually I prefer doing that if I'm out of ammo often, so. And how to unlock weapons, another thing, you have to hold a weapon to unlock it in the, gallery kind of thing. It's like a separate level where you can, I think it's an armory, right, so that's what it's called. So, you hold a weapon, unlock it in the armory. That's how, that's what you would want to do for that, for the most part, so. There's some you can unlock without, needing to hold. It depends, but for the most part, yes. No. Okay, so P for pause. Now, normal mode, P for pause works. In hard mode, you cannot pause the game or select the level. And if you lose, you have to start over from the beginning. So, this is an added difficulty as well as enemies generally doing a lot more damage and bosses as well, being more dangerous. Same as with the mouse, and left click for shoot. So, I think it goes over everything for the controls. You can change the keys if you want, but I think we're good. So, this is a little bit of lore, which I won't get into too much, since we'll go through that anyways. Then a couple other explanations, which you can read through if you'd like, but I'll go a little bit over weapon types, since this is a bit important to at least understand a little bit. So, starter weapon, handgun, my experience, not the best early on, like, in the start, it's better than nothing, but melee's also pretty good, so kind of on par with how powerful melee is, but a little more powerful, perhaps. Depends on the situation again. And a Magnum does like a lot of damage but has limited ammo, kind of like a pistol but like a lot of damage per hit. So, and a submachine gun. So, these can kind of waste a lot of ammo, but if you can stop up on it, they are pretty useful. So, like low damage but fast fire rate can make like damage per second go up quite a bit, I would say. And then a step above that would be an assault rifle, so it's like a better version of a submachine gun, except like a different kind of weapon, really. I guess that's how to explain that. So, and battle rifle, I don't have an image for it, but it's probably similar. So, like high damage, and yeah, shotgun. Okay, so for this, it's like a close range weapon, so it fires by pellets, and yeah, it's close range, lots of damage. These are really useful in boss fights, so. Yeah, I think, depends on if you have it or not, but anything, you have in a boss fight, you can use, really. And last, I think this will be last, special experimental weapons. So, again, those can be found in secret levels, secret areas, sorry, throughout the game. So, it can be a lot for achievements, so, which we'll get into in a bit. Alright, and in enemies, so there's some standard soldier, upgrade soldier, and so on. I won't get into this too much, it's a bit technical. There's more tips, which I kind of went over, mostly my experience, and you can read this if you want, but I mean, I think I went over everything, and yeah, let's get back to the game just a moment. Alright, before we start, let's go over options. So you can do anything really. I like to set quality low since I'm on a laptop, and I do prefer performance over quality for me personally, but it's up to you. And then you can level sound or change that, I guess, and yeah. So, next thing, as you can see, we do have another character customizer, and, well, let me enter a name first, actually. Yes, Cookie. Okay, there we go. I might not be able to see that, but yeah, it's type that. Okay, so, let's change the hair. I'm not a big fan of spiky hair, and there's kind of short hair. Let's go through. I'm looking for, like, the ponytail, actually, but it should be, somewhere. You can have fun with this if you want. You know, find a character you like, if you want to play the game. Okay. Alright, so I got the hair and face, and there's a lot of different faces as well. A lot of them have beards. I'm not a big fan of beards. Let me see. I'm just looking for like a hoodie, I think. Yeah, I have my character in mind, really, so. I'm trying to take too long, really. There's a lot of good outfits, though. I didn't have fun choosing one, so. It's like a trench coat, like a nice jacket for that one. Where are the hoodies? I'm thinking like a bigger red hoodie. Speak. No, not quite there. There we go. Okay. Kind of shoes. Let me scroll through here. Yeah, it should be these. Let me just make sure. Yeah, these should be the ones. Alright, got a custom character. Checking controls and everything. Okay. So, let's do a new game. Yeah. Alright, I'm gonna start a new game. Yes, backstory from the previous dating 3. We are dating 4, so just keep that in mind. Might not get the beginning of this too much, but that was the previous boss we fought in the last video I made, so if you're wondering. Yeah, okay, so anyways. It's been hours, as if the Hades prototype wasn't enough trouble. Now I'm stuck in this mess. Why did I have to be creative? Is all of this suffering really just for the sake of a more important weapon? How come it had to be me that was created for this? It's only been a couple days since it all began, trapped in my cell, waiting to be evaluated for my abilities. Muscle enhancers, behavioral suppressants, mind control, genetic purification. Test for effectiveness. Repeat until it works. I was designed to kill, and that's what I did. It seemed that Systems Corp hadn't anticipated that would all work so well. Poseidon was nothing but a bump in the road. I had finally gotten my first taste of freedom. I had escaped my containment cell and seen the real world outside for the first time. It was then that I knew that I had to pave my own way. I couldn't be slave to some demented corporate regime. Of course, this was the very last thing Systems Corp had in mind for me. They needed to recover their investment. They couldn't let me go, nor could they let me live. Because of their persistence, there is no running from the fight. They'll send everything they have, no matter how many people die. My genes are too valuable, and their secret is too vital. They've even gone so far as to send other experiments after me. The only way to end this is to go to the top and eliminate whoever is in control of all of this insanity. If I ever make it out of this containment chamber. Energy core that powered the Hades prototype. They stopped using these because they were too unstable and explosive. Looks like I may have a way out of here after all. I'll have my revenge on whoever created me. Nothing is going to stop me. Alright. Yeah, that's the story. So quite interesting. Alright, so again, I'm trying to do somersault dodges like this. I'm just kind of showing you this basically how you're going around most of the game, really. And so, there's the melee. And so I will show you this is how far. Now you see my screen just turned slightly different color and variety of color. That means you're taking a significant amount of damage. The more variety of people, the more dangerous you are in. So you can die in the game when the screen changes back to normal because they regenerate health. So you can regenerate health throughout the game to stay alive. So keep that in mind. And you need to jump to cover and then you can regenerate health there. Another thing. We are going to be forming a little bit of ammo and changing a couple of weapons. So now we have this. We want to change that. So we got a way to get another thing. I think it's a magnet. I want to try to get that. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Let's do this. There's a melee weapon. Okay. Next it is open, so we don't have to be right now, but that's okay. Just going to try to get different weapons from Abel, so you're not be able to get too much ammo. Okay, this is also useful for a lot of melee kills, so that if you want to get more melee kills later in the game, you can also do a special arena. I don't know what they're called, or not, but yeah, we'll get it later. I'm just going to spoil this. Yeah, all I'm doing right now is to use this part of the camera, so I'll leave it. Okay, that's fine. Alright. taking heavy damage. Keep someone from the center. Or if you go up here, it's gonna take time. I think I'm good. But that's just like the case that happens, so. It'll happen a lot, especially if you have really powerful weapons.
Okay.
took me to upstairs. So that's good. Okay. Alright, this is open. I'm gonna shred the muscle weapons as well. I'm gonna just be making it a really heavy fire. So, shred it careful. Continue? Yeah. Okay, so. Alright, elevator 2. Okay, that's about there. I would say stay down here. Yeah, this is a good tactic. Just tag it into the floor. Now, there will be another elevator later on. Not this one, it's the one where there will be more dangerous because the enemies will have their grenade launcher and taking heavy damage. Just be careful. Anyways, yeah, the one elevator I'm talking about, they should have been made from above. It'll kill other enemies and could cause a lot of damage and you end up killing you as well. So, quite dangerous. It is possible to dodge them, but doing so made all the other enemies jump around. So, in the tight elevator would be very dangerous. So, yeah. We'll go on it later, of course. So, yeah. Right. Open. So, let's continue. Alright, so we're in offices. This one starts getting dangerous soon. Some enemies will have grenades normally throughout these regular looking kind of areas. Office, actually. Okay, so. That works. Alright. Yeah, gonna work on that. And those machine guns will shoot faster as it takes more damage. So keep that in mind. Okay, so you can't run anymore. Ugh, I'm gonna need a bigger gun. Alright, here we go. Okay. So you shoot the back of the helicopter, which we'll get to in a minute. Just make sure I don't put the back on. Okay. That put more shooting to damage the helicopter. Alright? So we're gonna do that. You don't want to always shoot at, sometimes you want to go for the helicopter, depending on where it is. Keep in mind, staying alive is the most important thing. So here, okay. Sorry, I'm gonna spawn four. Those are grenades. Check if I can get the area open. Alright. Goodness. Okay. Take the door. So another thing, later on in the genetics lab, as we're in right now, is your series of levels, there are also zombies in order to fight against them. Oh no, we're not as well. We're different kind of enemies, so... not their point. Yeah, ooh, grenades, grenades! Okay. Do not duck in front of a shotgun, it will hit you. And as well as some machine guns to some degree. Yeah. Keep your rage away from the enemies if you're able to. You duck, that's what I would say. Okay. Alright. So, as you can see, there is a hidden room above us. They might just be able to see a bit of weapons up there just to take a glance. So, yeah, I'm going to go ahead and get some of those. So again, I did mention this before, no, it may sound a little redundant. If you can pick up a weapon, go unlock it in a special room. So it's important to do that even if you're not going to use it in the game. So just if you want to unlock all of them, just, you know, pretty achievement really. So, drop this weapon and this one. Okay, so this, school drill type thing. Can do like one shot damage, one kill type of damage really. Doesn't have a lot of ammo, don't really think I'm a big fan of this, but there's that, I just wanted to show you that. So, we have a laser cannon. So this shoots like a laser beam, I'll show you like that, and can go through multiple enemies, so quite useful. This is a Gauss shotgun, so kind of like a laser shotgun really, and yeah. Ammo-wise, really, I don't think it's gonna be that easy to pick up ammo for us, but I could be wrong. Some of the enemies do have laser type weapons, so yeah. Alright. And let's continue. Okay. So I should pick the enemies above us. What to do? It's kind of up over here. And safety is behind the corner, really. There's some of this. Try to lock the doors for able to. Ooh! Taking some heavy damage. This is terrifying. goodness, I think I'm fine. Okay, okay, so I'm gonna go up here as well if you like. Okay. Alright, and some base spawn here. Try to go here if you like. Ooh! Okay. Huh. Alright, couldn't stay too long, of course. Alright, let's bring him over. Okay, area is open. Let's continue. Okay, so up ahead should be some zombies, and I do apologize for getting a lot. I get a lot of the weapons, holding them, and all that. If I did not, I can go back and get them through. Should be able to as well later on. But anyways, there should be some zombies here, so let's look around. Yeah, right here. Now, they do not have any weapons, but they can grab you and attack and do a lot of melee damage, so I would say you can run and jump over them to avoid that for the most part. There's quite a few on the ground, so you might still take some damage from that, but yeah, for the most part, not too difficult of an enemy to take care of. If you keep your distance, and, you know, again, don't let them grab you. If you run out of ammo, you can, like so, kind of use the melee weapon. And if you want to save ammo, that is one thing you can do. See, they do take the few quarter of the damage, though, so yeah. Like a laser shotgun or a laser rifle. Depends on which one you still have to go for, I suppose. Okay. I'm sure if they do more damage, like certain ones, but yeah. Could be a thing, I guess I'll let you know. Okay. So, yeah, we're gonna use this gun weapon now. And you don't have to use all your ammo if you want to save some, but I think I'll be fine, really, so. Okay. Alright, so the area's open. Let's save the rest of this ammo for the next area. Alright. Looks like, oh, must have come from one of these areas, huh, interesting. Alright, so you can see, excuse me, there's another secret area with some guns up there, so let's go ahead and find the red switch and go ahead and go up there. Alright, so I think we just unlocked it, and yeah, we'll get the key card. There's some really good weapons here. Could keep this, or we could get rid of it. Really, it's up to us. I do like to use some new weapons as well if I'm able to. I think this should be fine. So here's like a really powerful, I think a rifle, really. Okay, so this type of shotgun is like an automatic shotgun. So you hold down the fire button and you can shoot rapid fire. You want to try to save some ammo, but I think that would be nice. And then, let me drop it real quick. This is a Desert Eagle. High damage. I don't know if we want that, but yeah, high damage. Somewhat low ammo, but if you want to use it, you can. I don't prefer doing it. It's a good weapon, I will say that, but I really do want to have enough ammo for this. Okay, so, alright, here's the hard part. It will be, the first room we'll go on is a bit of an open space kind of room, but there will be teleporters up above us, and enemies dropping down from below, so. And, what you want to do is to kind of backflip like this, or do double jumps, and so, to dodge bullets, and, yeah. After that, okay, I'm getting into a bit of detail here, this is important, because we're almost done with the game, this is the hard part. So after that, the elevator with the enemies with grenade launchers, that will be quite difficult, so, alright. Yeah, again, dodging grenades can actually be important to save your life, but at the same time, keep in mind, you don't want to jump too much in the elevator, or all the other enemies will jump, and it will be very dangerous. Whatever you're next to, will you do so with a melee weapon? I would prefer that. Okay. I think we're right. Didn't try to go over everything, but anyways. And yeah, last boss fight comes after all that as well, so, yeah. Which I would say, usually prefer using a melee weapon if you run out of ammo against them. And yeah, I'll go over it a bit. So, let's continue. Alright. And it is possible to jump on the platform as well. Oh, we got so much damage there. Okay. So if you take too much damage, go attack is the jump up there. Well, but I would not stay still on a platform with that grenade. You're not going to finish it off. Because staying still will cost you your life. And then you've tried that before to recover health above that thing. You'll be safe. I was not. That was a bad idea. Getting a lot of damage. Very risky, honestly. So, alright. That's pretty much it. Oh, goodness. Okay. Alright. Yeah, jumping in this area is a bad idea as well, so just keep moving and doing somersaults. That is important, so I'm gonna break above here. Just kind of show and because it's relatively safe up here in a second, but we'll keep spawning and that is a little bit of damage. Okay. Ooh. Don't want to use up too much ammo right away. And so, thing, but really, just go around the server you know is doing well. That's the important thing, because this is quite chaotic, so. Oh, yeah, we're gonna go for it. Okay. Not in close range to attacks. Last time my panic control for an awesome idea. Oh, it was close. That was so close. That's a great launcher. Okay, that's it. Can't stay there. Okay, I'm going to use melee against them. I don't care. I'm not going to try to take. I really hope I wasn't getting hurt too much, but I was about to die multiple times. And I think it's about time I use melee against them. Whatever I have in hand.
Okay.
Good, alright. Oh, okay. next to the enemy boss right there. Try to hit it with the melee weapon. Careful of the rifle here, that damage is exploding it too often. There's some damage and some careless. Okay, retreat.
Alright.
I can do this. Gotta get, oh my goodness. genetic effects, I guess. And whether or not your Labor Day won't affect my business or my sentiments one bit, I'll just tell you where you stand. My engineers clean up what they need to make another. It's a bit crude, but sometimes the simplest answers are the best. Goodbye, 154. You'll surely prove profitable in your next life. Alright, gonna try to stay alive as long as I can. Gonna run to the left, use our melee weapon, and try to kill them that are spawning over there. I don't know if you have any firearms, but that's not important. I'm going. Let's see. I can do this. Yeah.